Kosi Monga, that is in Cebuano, one of the main languages in the Philippines, which I just basically said, hello, my name is Monga. And today I'm here to share with you my experience, my journey to the Philippines together with other young people. Well, basically last year I was on the same program, which is called the Alternative Schoolies Immersion Trip to the Philippines program, which is run by the Sunhurst Diocese here in Victoria, which is like a group of young graduates, year 12 students who just finished high school, and instead they choose to embark on the journey to go in a third world country and try to make a difference. Not only that, also to experience and learn and walk side by side by brothers and sisters who are living a much harder life. To go in different communities as well as areas around Cebu. And we visited this village called Compostela. It's a small village. The people who are living in that village, they used to live in the slums area, so in the dump sites. But for those families that decided not to live in that situation, in that bad environment where, you know, the children get sick and it's a hard life, so it's hard to get through on everyday lives, where now in that community they get to make their own food and grow their own crops and so on. So I really love Compostela. We played different games with the kids. The kids were so lovely. We did a lot of some Australian songs and Australian dance and animal movements and so on and so forth. So they were really, really loved. I mean, the kids loved it. That was so. And the one thing that I really love about the Filipino kids was the fact that they are so joyful. And when I mean joyful, I'm not gonna say they're happy. I'm not gonna say that word because that is cliche. I think joyful is the word that I've been using, because while we're playing the games, right, get this, when we're playing the games in the circle, so like let's say the duck duck goose, the kids would be like, every time if somebody's running, they'll be like, you know, like clapping and jumping at the same time. So that's how happy and how joyful they were playing the games, and it was a great way to connect with them. And also Veronica took me around. But before going to the school, Veronica, she's like, Monga, I've got to feed my chooks or chickens first. And we're just like, okay.
This is the eggshell.
That's the eggshell?
Yeah.
Oh, it's not the eggshell?
No.
She accidentally put powder, soap powder, into the food.
It's the wrong... The wrong, you put soap in it. No, they're not gonna like that.
I didn't know what is this.
Right, that's okay.
I forgot.
So Veronica, she's feeding her
chickens?
Little chooks.
Chooks.
Wow, how pretty, there's 15 of them.
Yeah.
Amazing.
But yeah, and then after that, Veronica's so nice. She got the papaya out. She's like, oh, Monga, I know you're hungry, so I'll just get the papaya, the Filipino fresh papaya for you to have a taste and eat. And I'm like, oh, yes, please, please do. And yeah, so she was cutting the papaya very fine, done, and it was great.
So I requested from one of the family, or one of the manager here. What is your role here again, Veronica?
The chairperson
of Compostela. She's being very helpful, so she's so I've got the time to go to visit them at their school, so that's why I'm walking.
This walk is long, it's far, I must admit, and it's a narrow walk, like you walk into the bushes like this, and you know, and there's also hills and there's rocks. There's rocks everywhere, so, and grass and everything.
And here we are. We've reached the school where many of the kids from Compostela attend. And pretty much that's all the class in there.
So today we are going to visit a small village. It's like an island. And so we are going there by boat, and we're distributing some of the goods and also some of the foods and gift to the families there. So we went from the big boat and transferred to a little boat in order to get there, because there's not port for the big boat to actually reach the island. So therefore the people from the island, they have to bring the boat to where the big boat is, and then get all the stuff, all the goods and all the gift to the small boat and transfer that, and then just transfer. The visit to this island, we decided to jump in the ocean. We're all holding hands, we're ready to go, and we count 1, 2, 3. Guess what? Maisie Holland, she wasn't ready to jump in because she was scared. Maisie is scared to jump in the ocean. But anyway, so we just started to encourage Maisie. Come on, Maisie, Maisie!
Maisie! Maisie! Maisie!
Maisie! Maisie!
Maisie. Ah! Finally she did. Yes, hooray! So, but it was funny, it was good. Mario's funny, such a funny character, this one. Mario is one of the San Carlos ambassador, student ambassador. And so we were, you know, Mario was about to jump in, you know, like he was ready. We were all diving in the ocean, you know, diving. It was deep, but I managed to float on the water. It was too deep. But yeah, so Mario, we were ready to jump in the water, and we were, you know, everybody was just jumping in, diving. We did all the flips that you can imagine in the world. And Mario is ready to go! And guess what?
Go, Mario!
He did the frog jump. So that was hilarious. So laughing, it was funny. Oh, Mario. G'day, Mario. So the next day we went to a cemetery site. By the time we arrived at the cemetery, we were welcomed by a group of beautiful, beautiful ladies who sang for us the song of I Have a Dream.
I have a dream, a fantasy.
Something like that. It was amazing, and to hear just the voices and just to welcome us. We witnessed thousands and thousands people who are living in the cemetery, so it was hard to believe to see how actually some part of the world how people are living. So these people have no choice whatsoever because they've been abandoned. But on the other hand, there's people like us and there's other different organizations who are willing and who are put the time and effort to go out there and to try to bring hope. On the following day, we were able to visit Pook National High School. So I think it's like a public high school in Lisay City in Cebu. And so there we were also welcomed by a beautiful group of students as well as teachers there that were so welcoming. And we were presented by, you know, the music and the songs and dance. But speaking of music, I must say their music was on point, because they had a whole full, I think it's like a band or just a music class where students, they get to play different instruments, but it was all strings, so like double bass and guitars and different kind of strings of guitars.
Thank you.
sound of the music, you're like, wow, I'm just in heaven. And the sound, my Lord, it was absolutely spot on. Yeah, so it was, and also on that same note, us Aussies were able to present our, you know, our culture, to present our music and our dance, and here we are up among the gum tree, with lots of plum trees, tip for two, a kangaroo, a rose at the back, the ranger at the front, and an old rocking chair. Although I wasn't dancing, I was filming, so I was the cameraman to capture the moments for you guys. So it was a lot of fun, and also mingling with the students, and also get to hear their stories. So today we are visiting the biggest shopping mall in the Philippines, the SM shopping mall. When I mean big, this mall, it's massive, it's humongous, it's huge. So it's designed like a circle. So it's basically you can go around and around, and the shop, it's so modern, it's beautiful. It's actually great to be in it. So Gemma and I, we decided to go and discover the shop.
So we just got here in the Cebu City, and I am with this true Aussie lady here.
It's so fun.
We're being very ridiculous. It's so funny. So basically,
we got lost.
So we got lost. Oh, it's going up. Okay, cool, sorry.
Here we are, we'll turn this way. That's good. So here we are.
This big Christmas tree, look at that, like behind us. Look at that.
Oh my goodness.
Okay,
we're going to the top.
Oh, this is our pharmacy, Monga.
Oh, that is this. This is the one.
We've got it. So we finally found the pharmacy that we're looking for. So,
bye bye. We need to go down one. It's me.
I'm not going
all the way. We go down one.
Yeah.
Down one.
Ah, lady.
It's not my fault! Look!
Oh, there!
Yeah. Oh,
it's open, yeah?
Found it!
Good.
Thank you so much, Ma!
Yeah!
No, it's probably in there. So you see behind me? That's where the Christmas! Yeah!
They just launched a new shop. It's called the H&M. The H&M.
We have it in Melbourne.
Having Melbourne, which is good. And it is after all the.
I think it's downstairs.
Oh, we're going downstairs.
So after our hard work and, you know, going around the different areas within the Cebu, we got to experience different kind of the Philippines. So we were able, and I've got to tell you this, Philippines, it's a great, great, beautiful country. Not only this, it's because they've got beautiful, nice resorts. Oh my goodness, it is absolutely great. So we were, we had one day where we just went to a resort, which called the Plantation Bay, where we just enjoy ourselves and just relax and.
Oh, uh-oh, hello everyone. Where's the girls? Zoe, there's Zoe and. Look at them, Zoe. Oh, there's Kat. Oh, there's Gemma coming, Gemma. Just get the single, my girl. Get the single, there's Gemma. Gotta work as a team. They're struggling working out the double bike. Oh, there we go. There's Mr. Hey. Oh. All right, girls, we're still waiting for you all.
All right. Oh, my God.
Oh.
I got it, everybody!
Everybody's ready!
Girls, the other ones have already left us. Look at them struggling. They're about to change their mind there. Alright, we'll swap then. We'll swap.
I can't do it!
Okay!
I can't do it!
Alright, we'll swap.
We could hear you screaming the whole area.
My young hapon. Hey.
Hey Monga, what are you doing?
Today I'm with my pals and we do some rock climbing, mate.
And Kat, she is struggling.
Look at her behind. Oh, cat.
Oh. Keep going, Moy.
Oh, cat.
Wait, you already were?
I'm struggling already.
Oh, look at those back muscles.
Yeah, man, look at that. Because I come from the land of plenty.
Together with other amazing young people, it was the best. It was an experience of a lifetime. Not only that, the journey was just, I thank God for the opportunity, and I thank for the people for believing in me and also for supporting me, and as well for the Filipino people. I mean, the country is, it's a beautiful country to visit, and I do recommend for you, for your honeymoon maybe, for holiday vacations or anything that you want, basically, check out the Philippines. And this is to all the U12 students in my area under the Sandhurst Diocese in Victoria. So I would definitely recommend for you to check it out and to talk to your parents about it. It's a great way to experience, and it's not only experiencing, to immerse into a different culture and get to different language and to different food and so on and so forth. And also to see how other people living in perhaps in a developing country where people don't have the same resources or the many fortunate that we do have. So go and check it out. Bye bye. How do we say bye bye in the Philippines? Don't cut it. How do you say bye bye? Bye.